We want to complete a table of values for the function f of x equals x cubed minus 4x, and then use the information from the table to graph the function. When we're given a function like this, if it's helpful, we can replace f of x with y, so we can write this as y equals x cubed minus 4x, if that's helpful. Now we'll select values for x, and determine the corresponding function value, or y value. And each time we do this, we'll be determining one point that would be on the graph of the function. So let's use x equals negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. And if this isn't enough information to graph the function, we'll find additional points. So to determine the function value, or y value, when x equals negative 2, we'll substitute negative 2 for x. So we'd have negative 2 to the third minus 4 times negative 2. Well, negative 2 cubed is negative 8, and then minus 4 times negative 2 would be plus 8. Negative 8 plus 8 would be equal to 0. So this tells us that the graph of the function would contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 2 and a y-coordinate of 0, which would be this point here. Next, we have x equals negative 1. So the y value would be negative 1 cubed minus 4 times negative 1. Negative 1 cubed is negative 1. This becomes plus 4, so that would be equal to 3. So the function contains the point negative 1, 3, or this point here. When x equals 0, we would have a function value, or a y value, of 0 cubed minus 4 times 0, which is 0. So the graph passes through the origin, or the point 0, 0, this point here. Next we have x equals 1, so we'd have a y value of 1 cubed minus 4 times 1. It's going to be 1 minus 4, or negative 3. This gives us the point 1, negative 3, which is this point here. And then we have x equals 2, so we have 2 cubed minus 4 times 2. It's going to be 8 minus 8, which is 0. So we have the point 2, 0, which is this point here. And this should be enough information to graph this function. It's going to pass through these 5 points. So looking our way from left to right, the graph is going to start down here, pass through the x-axis, reach a high point, turn, pass through the origin, reach a low point here, turn, and pass through the x-axis again. So the graph will look something like this. Notice how this is a degree 3 function, and this graph has 1, 2 turns in it. It is true that a polynomial function has at most n minus 1 turns, where n would be the degree of the function. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.